becomes available, I want that money to come to the school district. Period. So whatever number we arrive at for parent contribution, be it $150, $165, whatever it happens to be, that's what it's going to pay. I don't want to go back and be renegotiating this based on the fact that the state comes in with money.
Would we have some sort of a subsidy for families or just aren't able to afford that, and so how would we manage that?
I think we have to do something like that.
Yeah, we talked about that in our committee and talked about, you know, handling it the same way that we do Chawonki and,
I mean, do they just come to you?
Do we say? We do have a procedure that people do that, and come and they let us know, and we handle it ourselves through our guidance department, so that it's as comfortable as possible for people. But one of the things about the $150 to think about, and we talked about it in this committee, most of our families, because of courses that kids take, will buy things like a scientific calculator and other kinds of things that are already on the laptop. You do not have, that's not an addition. A scientific calculator that you would use in high school is going to cost you about $100 or so. Plus, they have a full set of encyclopedias, they have a thesaurus, they have all of those things. So for that $150, you're buying a lot of resources, some of which is money you would have spent anyway, and some of it is additional perhaps.
What we've learned since though is that it's not a question for the center.
At the high school.
Oh, it doesn't work.
Elaine Brownell came in and spoke to us about that.
But
well, the other ones are there anyway.
But we can talk about the split. I mean, that's
right. Where does, when we, you know, when you have a family in need, where does that subsidy money come from?
It comes from money that we have in our fundraising, or money that the Parents Association would help us with. Other times, the Student Council has helped us with money. However, usually the way we do our money for that, we figure out a flat fee for those, and we don't absolutely empty the account, so that we know we're going to need a little bit of money in that account for scholarship programs.
So don't you have some sort of program for that type of situation with your adult ed courses?
We use the formula that they use for free and reduced lunches.
But where does the money, the actual cash come from?
We absorb some of it.
Right.
Out of other program revenues, and we have had the opportunity to apply to Tom Jordan Trust fund in the past to help subsidize some of those scholarships.
And that requires an application. I'm not overly familiar with the fund. I just know it's there, and I know some of the things that it's been used for. That's
it. And we don't have a formal application for other programs, much smaller amount of money, kind of thing that we're looking at, but you know, for a program like this, it would be easy to come up with a formal application.
If I could just shed some light on the Thomas Jordan Trust, the Thomas Jordan Trust, as you know, probably most of the rest of you don't know, is a trust that was set up because of this, the money came from the sale of what was known as the town bond. And that money is invested, and it throws off a certain amount of income every year. However, it's been hit very hard the last few years because of what's been happening with the economy. And the money available has been communicated to Sue that there is pretty much a cap on what she has available for the programs she does for camp scholarships and things like that. So there's really not too much money.
I was going to say it was pretty capped because they said we would never be able to get any more even if there was a need for more.
We'd have to be the town counselors are also act as the trustees of that trust, and we would be dipping into the principal, so there was not really much money there.
And we apply on
the
annual
basis. But the reality is that someone who met the criteria could apply.
Could apply, but as I said, we're pretty capped out.
No, I understand.
Right now, so you can apply, but it doesn't mean, you know, I mean, if a lot of people started applying, you might get 1 month.
Gary, I have a question. I know the cost
of them took advantage of our summer offerings at Cape Academy, and they paid for some to go to, Yarmouth has a week-long session over there. Many of the seventh grade and eighth grade staff took advantage of that, and that's part of my regular staff development budget.
They were on board, existing money to have that.
Correct.
And is, are the staff development, you're thinking of planning is similar to what they've done for middle school with the content area streams that they've been running out of the roster, and there's places to know what those 3 days are?
I'm not sure exactly what those are, but I think that's what they want to base it on.
Because those of the training that we had access to from the Yoki program, we had two basic types from the state, the sort of two-day thing in the summer, get acquainted with your laptop. It was not a good match with us, and we found out soon enough by more of the eighth grade teachers, we found some other ways to support them and go for our own academies. But one that's been very strong are regional content area meetings where teachers meet. A lot of times our region has met in the Gloucester area, the old Pineland site, and people have come and shared things that they've worked in, language arts, social studies, and shared with other content area teachers. Those have been very strong.
It's, we can deal with the, of how to use the laptop and the basic stuff here. It's the integration piece that, that the state can do as well.
I
wanted
to ask Jeff what the input from or response or feedback from the ninth grade staff has been regarding this.
I've talked a number of times with department chairs and ninth grade teachers, and really at a faculty meeting with all the teachers. Just a quick summary of the reaction of teachers is they're very excited about the possibility of having kids have laptops to enhance the learning, and having teachers have laptops so that they can keep up to speed with where the kids need to go. The number one concern of teachers, without exception, is the technology staff support that Gary is asking for to make sure that they will be up and running and will be reliable. It really has. There's support for the idea, the support for the integration. They know they can use it. They know they will use it. They want it to be usable on a regular basis.
And Gary also wanted to ask, does that fee, that $315 include insurance?
It does not.
It does not. Okay, so then that would be an additional cost to the parent.
If
which
we,
is how it's handled now.
Right. Right. Many of the schools, insurance claims haven't been that great, and schools are, at least what I'm reading, listservs are basically doing self-insuring. When issues happen, they deal with it themselves. Instead of, so that's something that we need to look into. Is the insurance really cost effective?
Didn't we have a conversation about this in our committee about tying that whole package together so that whatever we would charge the parent, you know, whether it's $150 or $2, that would include the insurance,
right.
So it would be a one-cost thing, I think.
Right.
So then that would raise, if we went
it would
that
raise
route,
that.
We would raise that.
It would, the insurance, yeah. I got a quote for the insurance, and I think it was like $40, $41 for the school year to cover a laptop.
And I have another question. On the, what Nancy was saying about the professional development for the teachers, did Apple say to us that those 3 days, we could make, they could tailor them to what we needed?
Right. I wasn't there at that meeting, but that was my understanding.
Okay. Well,
I heard that too.
Right. So that, because you had expressed that it wasn't right for seventh and eighth grade teachers, it was a little too basic for them, right? And she said that they could tailor make it for us for what we needed.
So that was part involved, you know, incorporated in part of that cost.
Use the program. Right, and the based
on which are vital. Right. Any other questions? It's a lot. So we will continue on Saturday. Thank you.
If you want more detailed surveys, it's just kind of a different version of what's there, but it's
really controversial.
Thank you.